that's a chert, and so it's very fine grain quartz, and the red is a rock called jasper.
I drive down the eastern freeway and I find myself running off the side of the road because I'm looking at the rock face and the road cutting. I can't, it's terrible. I'm a dangerous driver. I just find myself looking at rocks in the real world all the time. I just can't help it. I teach the field camp every year. This year was my 13th year of teaching it. It's evolved quite a little bit. We go out for nearly 3 weeks into the remote area of outback Australia and the students camp, and we teach them how to read rocks and interpret the geology based on their observations. I think it's very important for the students because that's where they usually make most of their lifelong friends. We often end up finding ourselves in remote areas where we have to be quite cautious about the way we behave. I call it rock legs, so the more you walk over rocks, the better you are at it. It's rugged terrain, and I find a rocky terrain just as beautiful as a vegetated terrain. I was the first person out of both sides of my family to ever go to university. My first year at uni was a bit of a disaster. I was a country boy and headed off to the big smoke, and when I started I couldn't even use a computer properly. So in the 25 years since then, you know, all I use is a computer.
Can you see all those bubbles there?
Yep.
They're earthquakes.
Happening now?
Or? No, over time, they're recorded. And you can see they're making a surface, can't you?
Yeah.
See that?
Yeah.
So that is a subduction zone.
I like big scale processes, so I like looking at the big picture and trying to understand how many small bits build up a jigsaw puzzle to solve a larger problem. I've just come off a 10-year program of trying to understand the evolution of the ancient part of Australia, and I'm increasingly finding myself more interested in the modern earth. So when I was in year 10, I was known in the town for being a footballer, and I wasn't a stellar student. And so one day, one of the local butchers knocked on my dad's door and said, "We've got a part-time job available that we want to find an apprentice." And I spent 3 or 4 days seriously considering whether I would be a butcher or not, which is, you know, worlds away from where I've ended up 25, 30 years later.
So I like to use thicker, more violent hammers. So sometimes extracting a rock is surgery, and other times it's brute force, and I'm not very good at the surgery bit of it, so I tend to smack rocks as hard as I can, and whatever comes out I'll deal with.